assets, opportunities even, that you may lose.
You must ask yourself if you love the people, because the only thing that can bind you to the people you serve is love. Ambition is not enough.
I have discovered the power of kindness, and that has made me a radical optimist. That's why I stay away from politics and from religion.
Countries that take unilateral action or coercive action
actually like Pinoy personally.
It's not a beauty contest who's ahead of who, but to...
Once upon a time, we were all irrelevant. And I sincerely believe that there will come a time we will all return to the dark embrace of irrelevance.
Martin's Mancave.
This is the program Martin's Man Cave on Podcast.ph. We are with the former senator and human rights lawyer, attorney Rene Saguisag. Kanina, sir, bago tayo nag-break, you told me that na-meet mo yung bonus mo doon sa Boston.
Dahil may tumawag na common friend, You have to meet this woman. And then one day, I was in a Harvard Law Dormitory. May call nga daw. Kasi hall yun eh. Tatawagin ka ng mga kasama mo sa hall. A call for you. So on the line was Dulce. So we chatted and agreed to meet. At the time, I thought I was not the marrying kind. Pero nung una kong makita, at the very least, half in love kagad. And then, in a few weeks, parang MU, mutual understanding. And she was then in Boston College on a full scholarship as a social worker. Dahil when she took the board here after UP, number 3 sa board yan eh. Una niyang trabaho sa Pangpalay. So, yun nga, we cared for the poor. So, parang we were professional, emotional, and intellectual equals. Kaya, at saka, ang bait-bait. So, I wish she... we're still here, pero talagang that was why nung madisgrasya kami, I was told na many people went to the wake in St. Isko, her alma mater. They extended ang viewing from 10 to midnight. Nandun na si na Pangulong Cory, na Pangulong Erap. And it took a while after I got out of the hospital to try to readjust the new situation. Could not understand it, but that was the will of the Lord. So I was accepting. And then the apos started coming. So not a total replacement, but to a very great extent. Talagang when I see them, I see her. Dahil talagang ang ambisyon niya, pangarap niya, ang dream niya, maging lola. And iba yung anak, mahal mo, no? Pero ang apo, ibang arrive o dating. Kaya the eldest is 7 now, Rene the 3rd, no? And then si Tala, ang pangalawa, then Dulcet, and then si Derek, at yung huli si si Nicole, and I live for them.
What about Dulce, that you will never ever forget?
Well, talagang ano eh, yung helpmate, companion, friend. I cannot describe how mabait she was. And many people who went to the wake told me later that they were so grateful na hindi ko alam ang daming natutulungan, kasi siya cancer survivor. And marami siyang natulungan na mga referrals, mga ganon. There's only one word to describe her. She was perfect.
If you were to define love based on your experience with Dulce, how would you define it?
Well, she was so selfless and so giving. And, talagang kasi lahi ng mga social workers yung dahil yung eldest nila and the one who followed her, social work sa UP din. Yung hipag niya, social work sa UP din. Talagang nasa nature nilang, kasi ano yan eh, yung Maramba from Pangasinan. And Governor and Senator Daniel Maramba, a very well-loved public figure, Pangasinan history, our national history. Kaya it's a very kind, compassionate family. And yan ay namana ko rin sa mami ko. Kaya yun niya, imagine, hindi ako kinukulit na bigyan mo naman kami ng bahay, etc.
What is your only regret during the lifetime of Dulce?
Ano, at my age, 76, whatever bad events, misfortunes, I find myself accepting na lang eh. Kasi in 2013, I flew to the U.S. accompanied by someone to attend the graduation of my daughter, who was getting her doctorate in Rutgers. And in the long flight to New York, one of the movies shown was God is Bigger Than Elvis. Ito yung si Dolores Hart, the first woman who at 19 was kissed by Elvis Presley on screen. But at 25, she left Hollywood to Connecticut to join a Benedictine order. At yun, may famous interview siya na tinanggap niya na, I don't understand, but it's the will of the Lord, so I accept. So ganun din, kung ano man ang pagsisisihan ko, wala eh, dahil I really believe na God gives you what you pray for or something better. Mm-hmm. At ako, disipulo na rin ni President Cory, believe na, nung deliver niya sa Boston College, mm-hmm, I pray with all my heart, I work with all my might, and the rest I leave to God. So, eh ngayon, dahil kung 76 at may baston, any moment, tatawagin ka ni San Pedro o ni Kalawit eh. Eh, ang balita ko dyan, walang motion for reconsideration doon yun. Kaya yun niya na sana naman, eh, pagtimbang-timbangin, baka make weight, eh, maybe I did more good than bad.
Senator, babasahin ko po itong isa sa mga quotable quote na nabanggit niyo po. Noong February 2, 2006, you said, "I thought we had a very good beginning in 1987. We assembled a very good Supreme Court. Our Senate, I thought, was a good one. We had a good cabinet, and I thought that our successors would build on these." What happened?
Well, kasi nung, I think one of the flaws in the 87 Constitution, multi-party, which I thought was more fitted kung parliamentary. Mm-hmm. A parliamentary lost by one vote. Kasi nung araw, before you would become a senator, salan-sala na kayo yung sa 8-member slate. Uh-huh. Eh ngayon, talagang unang-una, nung 1987, I felt insecure. Mm-hmm. Ano bang ginagawa ko dito? Eh, sina Recto, Laurel, Jokno. Pero looking at those who followed us, mukhang okay na rin kami. dahil yun ang isang problema na may iwasan ba natin sa Senado, where I once worked, no? Wag mo na lang magganong pagsasabi. Pero ngayon, no, karamihan, may mga nakapasok doon kasapi ng partidong pinabili ng suka. Eh. Lawmaking is very serious business. Mm-hmm. You are responsible for 104 million rabbits. Kaya not just anybody can be sent doon. And the Senate is not a part-time mm-hmm. hobby or whatever. Mm-hmm. Dahil, you know, they will decide what will happen to my apus. Wag na yung sa akin dahil ako eh, malapit na rin sigurong tawagin kahit anong samanda mo, may katapusan din eh. Pero, but those who will follow me deserve better.
Sir, isa po kayo sa pumirma para umalis na yung US bases. You were one of the signatories of that. You voted against
the 1991.
Yes. And ngayon, nandito ulit sila sa atin through EDCA. Sinasabi ng mga mambabata, sinasabi ng mga pro-EDCA that we need the Americans because we cannot defend ourselves.
Noong 1941, eh, the entire country was one huge military base. Inatake tayo ng Hapon, wala rin nagawa si Kanoto. Eh. In other words, mm-hmm. itong kasaysayan natin, we may be competing for the dishonor of having been under foreign domination for hundreds of years. Mm-hmm. Kay Castilla, Ingles, Amerikano, Hapon, Amerikano uli, Ilocano, eh talagang lahing alipin, lahing busabos eh. Uh-huh. Kaya dito, I voted no mm-hmm. in 1991 to cut short itong being a colony for hundreds of years. After that, we can enter into any agreement with any country. I agree with Palmerston. A country has no permanent friends, no permanent enemies, only permanent interest. In other words, ano bang kasaysayan ng Amerikano dito? Lumuhod si McKinley, sinabi raw sa kanya ng Panginoon, go to the Philippines, Christianize the country. Eh ano ba yung ginawa ng mga Kastila hundreds of years earlier? Pagkatapos, Balangiga, ilan ang tinepok ng kano in retaliation for the massacre of Balangiga? Figures vary from 2,500 to 50,000 Filipinos. Mount Budadyo sa Sulu, ilan ang tinepok? 1,000 Muslim warriors, women and children. In other words, kailangan balanse niyan. Ang kanta nila noon, oh, the monkeys have no tails in Zamboanga. Ganon, tingin sa atin mga unggoy. They may be brothers of Bilta, but they are no brothers of mine. Civilize them with a crag, baril. Now, I don't forget or overlook the many good things Americans have done. Pero yun nga, noong 1991, President Cory called Butch Aquino and me to the palace and asked for our votes. Pero sinabi namin, us as another. Ito namang si Noy, no? Eh, kami namumuno na magdemanda sa kanya sa Korte Suprema for EDCA. Ang gusto lang namin to observe the institutional, constitutional process. Idaan sa Senado. Who would have said no? No one. That even Manong Johnny says, for EDCA siya. And this was the same person who said in 1991, it's an insult to our race na kung wala Amerika, wala na tayo. And so, yun nga, meron pa siyang memorable speech about we will survive even after the last bar girl will have turned off the last bar light in Olongapo. Kaya, kung yan dinan ni Noy sa Senado, palagay ko unanimous ang boboto eh. Dahil dito, pag nagplebisito ka sa statehood, baka manalo pa eh. Eh, to me naman, kailangan manindigan tayo kamukha ng Vietnam. Tinalo ang France, tinalo ang Kano. 1979, nilusob ng Inchek. Turned back ang Inchek. 30,000 people were killed. Both sides. Eh dito, apat lang ang sumalakay na special operation ng police. Hanggang ngayon, usapan ng mga sapano. Aba, eh, pag pumasok ka sa service, any moment, you have to be ready to shed blood. Magbuhos ang dugo para sa bayan. Kaya, in other words, EDCA, nandyan na yan, pero whether the Americans would respond quickly, we don't know. Kailangan tayong mag-develop ng puso ng Vietnamese. Miski sino ka pa, handa kami magbuhos ng dugo para sa bayan.
Senator Saguisag, sir, tell us about your children.
Well, we have five, no? May lawyer, yung eldest. Mm-hmm. Ngayon, UAAP commissioner. Dahil sa UP, Human Kinetics. Mm-hmm. And then si Lara, si yung Rene Andre, Soviet dissident yun eh. Lara naman, doon sa Dr. Zhivago, ay dissident din yun. Mm-hmm. Meron doctorate, doctor of philosophy, nagtuturo ngayon sa New York. And then the third, merong degree from UP, doubling in business. The fourth is in law school. Mm-hmm. The last si Kaisa was a gymnast who won a gold for the Philippines, I think in 2004. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And ngayon, nagtuturo na ng gymnastics to young people. So, I think that they're okay. Yung eldest ko, Rebo, is married to a classmate who now a judge in Makati. In my second, meron din mga sarili silang enterprises, mga computers, etc. So, by the grace of a compassionate providence, mm-hmm. they seem to be all right. I mean, mm-hmm. mga problema, pero who doesn't, no? Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Ano yung mga usual na advice that you give your children or your apos? Ano yung mga usual na binibigay mo sa kanila ng words of wisdom?
Well, Kasi kami San Beda, ano namin din eh, ora et labora eh, no? And my kids, ito mga lalaki, puro San Beda yan hanggang high school eh.
Mm-hmm.
Lara naman, Saint Isko, for them to work and pray. And like Corey would say, God will do the rest. Work with all your might, pray with all your heart, the rest you leave to God. And siguro, by example then, mm-hmm. I don't know kung paano they could see how hard I worked, no, mm-hmm. before our tragedy. Kasi na isang ano ng Pilipino, yung work ethic. Eh. Kasi in the West, they say, when it rains, you take shelter from the rain.
Mm-hmm.
Tayong Pilipino, we sing and dance in the rain. Ay, tayong, imagine last year, July pa lang, nakakadinig na ako ng Christmas carols. Longest holiday season.
Uh-huh.
Talagang land of party animals. Last.
Who are the people that you would like to say thank you at the end of this journey?
Well, why am I here today? Thank you, Mr. Marcos. Meaning, kung wala yung batas militar at yung opresyo niya, pag nanakaw niya, I would have been siguro just an ordinary lawyer na, in other words, Mr. Marcos made me famous, made me win in 1987 without spending a single centavo of my own. Kaya thank you, Makoy. But seriously, mga magulang ko, mga teachers, kasi sabi nga ni Henry Brooks Adams, a teacher affects eternity. He never knows where his influence stops. Very good teacher sa Makati Elementary, very good sa Rizal High, very good sa San Beda, very good sa Harvard. So I learned a lot from them. And of course, people like President Cory, my Mabini colleagues, maraming dapat pasalamatan,
mm-hmm.
Beginning kay Daddy at kay Mommy.
Mm-hmm.
Yung kuya ko, napakabahid. Kasi kami ang parehong nasa Makati Elementary, siya ang paborito ng kaka ko.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya maraming datong. Ayun, sineshare sa akin. So, in fact, talagang I owe a lot to so many people. So, whoever you may be, thank you, thank you, thank you.
You're very patriotic. And if you had one last chance of talking to the entire population before you leave, what would you tell the population, the Filipinos?
Well, siguro I'll just borrow from Ted Kennedy, no, noong 1980, after he had lost yung Democratic National Convention. Nagpasalamat na sa mga tumulong sa kanya, dinagdag. And to all those whose cares have been our concern, the work goes on, the cause endures, the hope still lives, and the dream shall never die. Unquote.
Thank you so much for your time, Attorney Rene Saguisag.
Okay, tira.
Mabuhay po kayo, sir.
Thank you.
And that has been our 83rd episode of Martin's Man Cave, the Lifecast here in podcast.ph with Senator Rene Saguisag. You can download the episode for free on iTunes. You can watch us on YouTube. Or you can go to Spreaker. You can go to Podomatic, Stitcher. You can go to SoundCloud. Or better yet, go straight to our website, www.podcast.ph. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for listening.
This podcast.ph presentation is supported by Martin Andanar's Homecast Studio and Audio.ph.